Meanwhile, next week, First Lady Melania Trump is hosting a gathering at the White House.
Yes, she will be speaking with social media executives about helping to prevent cyberbullying. She's expected to talk to them about what they've done to combat online harassment. But while she's talking about cyberbullying, one thing she will not be talking about is the Stormy Daniels saga. Joining us now to discuss this, CNN White House reporter Kate Bennett. Kate, good morning to you. And we've not heard anything from the First Lady or from the President about this.
That's right. We haven't heard from the First Lady. In fact, we haven't heard from her discuss any of her husband's bad press or the headlines about women since 2016, when she addressed the aftermath of the Access Hollywood tape, saying that her husband had apologized to her. But since then, you know, she's been very quiet. I have to say it's a strategy that's sort of worked well for her. She remains the most popular Trump family member in terms of polling. She's garnered support from different corners and just in her silence alone. And I think the ways that she has spoken out, be it canceling her trip to Davos or taking a separate vehicle up to the State of the Union, or taking a separate motorcade just a couple of weeks ago to meet the President at Andrews Air Force Base rather than walk across the South Lawn with him, these are all things that her office says are due to scheduling and logistics. However, if we want to read into this, it could be her just exerting some mode of independence in the wake of all of these really salacious headlines.
All righty, so let's take a look at a list here that has been compiled by Victor, doing his research here, of insults that the president has used against people via Twitter. We've got little, we've got short, fat, overrated, lightweight, unhinged, flunky, flaky, crying, weak, sleepy-eyed, loser, clown, crazy. It just goes on and on. Pocahontas, wacky, sneaky. With that said, a lot of people view him as being guilty of online bullying. What is Melania Trump's influence at this meeting, giving what we see from her husband?
Melania Trump's office has said to me when I asked about this whether her tackling a topic like cyberbullying is sort of flying in the face of the attitude of her husband. And her office says she doesn't care. There's nothing about what she's doing that really is cohesive with the president in terms of her messaging, and that's fine with her. She's independent. And I think that's interesting. If you think about past administrations, imagine if Michelle Obama had said that about Barack Obama's agenda or attitude. So I think, you know, she could be the ultimate troll of her husband. Here she is picking a topic to fight that is something that her husband, as that list indicates, is sort of goes forward with name calling. So I think it's interesting. It's the First Lady doing something that she knows is going to add extra emphasis, extra pressure, picking a topic like this. However, I think she feels it's important. I think she's living with an example of perhaps what not to do, and in a way that could help even make the spotlight greater. I mean, we're discussing it. I don't think she just wants to focus on cyberbullying. Her office tells me it's also just about time online, what kids are seeing online, and general kindness online and sort of social habits. So it's all of these things combined. But yeah, I really, from covering the First Lady, I think she would prefer if her husband sat in and perhaps paid attention, but I don't think what his attitude is about social media and how he uses it is really something she is going to let stop her or influence her as she moves forward in this case.
Hmm. So it takes every First Lady some time to decide what that platform will be, how they will best use their time in the White House. Is this the platform that she has chosen? Cyberbullying, as you mentioned, this meeting will be more about children's time online. But is she growing beyond that? Is she expanding beyond that? Or is this the laser focus for the First Lady?
So she has yet to announce a formal platform, sort of like we think about Michelle Obama and a Let's Move or Barbara Bush and her reading initiative. Melania Trump has just given a broad umbrella so far of helping children. And that can mean anything from, you know, helping them struggle with social media or online issues, health, wellness, the opioid abuse and how it affects families in this country. So she's certainly chosen something where we could really we're sort of looking for her to hone in on one or two things or topics, but right now it's just sort of helping children writ large.
All righty. Kate Bennett, thanks for walking us through it. Appreciate it.